Louis Vuitton store. Now, after an initial statement saying the situation wasn't a big deal, LeVar Ball, he's gone quiet. Early reports were that they could face serious prison time. President Trump acknowledged that he brought up the issue with Chinese President Xi Jinping during his recent visit to Beijing. And now, Pac-12 Commissioner Larry Scott saying that, quote, the matter has been resolved to the satisfaction of the Chinese authorities, thanking the White House, the State Department, and the president for their efforts. The three UCLA players boarded a Delta flight from Shanghai to Los Angeles today. Take a look at the flight tracker. They are making their way back as we speak to the United States. So where in the world are they? Let's turn to ESPN basketball insider Jeff Goodman, who has been following them pretty much all over the world. Jeff, all right, what's the latest?
So they will land about 5 o'clock local time, and then tomorrow at 11 in the morning, they will address the media with statements, each one of the three players. And then Steve Alford, the head coach, will also make a statement, as will athletic director Dan Guerrero. I talked to Jalen's father a little while ago, and he did not want to comment at this point. But you could sense the relief in his voice that his son is headed home, one of the three freshmen that will again arrive in L.A. about 5 o'clock.
Yeah, and there they are right there boarding the flight earlier today. I have to imagine LeVar Ball pretty relieved as well. So, Jeff, what happens next for these young men, do you think, as it relates to their careers at UCLA?
Well, the big question is tomorrow, within Steve Alford and Dan Guerrero's statements, do these three kids get suspended or do they get cut loose from the program? That's the big thing right now, and a lot of people wondering whether it's not best to move on from the Ball family. Remember, the youngest Ball, Mello Ball, now with LeVar overseas, he's being homeschooled, committed to UCLA, but most people feel like he will never play a game in a college uniform. So do you move on from the Ball family? Do you cut these three players loose, or do you suspend them for a period of time?
Yeah, and UCLA chancellor saying they take these violations of law seriously. They're reviewing the incidents. One quick thing, I have a couple seconds. What does this do for the image of college basketball?
Well, listen, the FBI investigation, now this leading up to two big games tonight. I'm here in Chicago, Champions Classic, on 1-2 Duke, Michigan State, Kansas, Kentucky in the nightcap. We need games because there have been plenty of black marks on college basketball, this being the latest.
Yeah, Jeff, great point. We don't want to talk about this. We really want to be focused back on those games, but we'll see what happens here. Jeff Goodman, thank you.
Thanks, Rod.
And while the UCLA kids are coming home, NFL ownership accusing Jerry Jones of going too far off the reservation. The NFL's compensation committee firing back at Jerry Jones, who accused them of misleading he and his fellow owners about critical facts on the talks of Roger Goodell's still being negotiated contract. Now, the committee warning Jones to stand down on his threat to sue. So, do you think Jerry Jones took that lying down? Here he is today, responding to reports that owners could have the option of booting him from their ranks.
I've had not one inkling of communication from the league office or any owner that would suggest something that laughable and ridiculous.
Committee Chairman Arthur Blank adding that the committee is continuing its work towards finalizing a contract extension with the commissioner and will keep ownership apprised of the negotiations as they move forward. Now, naturally, Jones isn't feeling that approach.
Roger has almost 18 months. He has 18 months left on him. We've got all the time in the world to evaluate what we're doing. We've got all the time in the world to extend him. We just need to slow this train down and discuss the issues at hand in the NFL.
All right, joining me now for a deep dive into the deep divide between Jerry Jones and NFL owners, Louis Riddick. Jason Reed first, actually, senior NFL writer for The Undefeated. All right, so Jason, let's talk about this. You know, what does the committee statement do to Jones's point at this point? How does this affect him?
Well, you know, as you know, Ryan, he could take the option of following through with threatening on the litigation, but in terms of the committee, I mean, they've made it clear, look, we're done with you. Just stop this now. We're moving forward in the negotiations. We're going to get this thing done. We're going to get this extension done through 2024. And basically they're telling him, just be quiet now. You've had your say. You have done what you feel you needed to do, but it's over now. Just be quiet.
So does he have any power at this point to stop the negotiation train?
Well, Ryan, he could follow through on the litigation. I mean, he hired high-powered attorney David Boies earlier this month, and this is a guy who obviously has had a lot of success going after people in the legal world and doing those types of things. But here's the thing. Around the league, people are looking at this like, okay, you're upset, you're throwing a tantrum because Ezekiel Elliott got suspended for 6 games. I was talking to an NFL general manager about another story the other day, and out of the blue, Ryan, he just stopped and just went into this thing. And he's just telling me how people around the league are just laughing at him because they all see what the underlying thing is here. He's furious about this Ezekiel Elliott suspension. And you can debate whether or not this contract extension is right in terms of what the numbers that ESPN has reported out there, $49.5 million a year, the use of a private jet, health insurance for Roger Goodell's family for life. If those things are something you want to discuss and debate, that's legitimate. But in terms of the NFL and its rules, right now the compensation committee is moving forward, and he is not part of the compensation committee anymore.
You know what's interesting here? So we know the NFL, you're talking about how the owners are looking at him, but we know the NFL really cares about what it looks like from the outside looking in, what fans think, what other people think of them. So what does that look like right now? What do the outside of the owners, the NFL, the fans, everyone else, what does it look like looking into them?
Well, I think, Ryan, you look at it two ways, partner. You look at what the numbers are out there, and for the average fan, like, wait a minute. I mean, $49.5 million and lifetime insurance and the lifetime use of the jet. And then, you also look at it from the perspective of it's a war between the owners, or a war between Jerry Jones and the rest of the owners. And it's a clearly a bad look. And, taking that further, there's reporting out there that some owners actually want the league to do something to punish Jerry Jones. I don't believe this talk, Ryan, about trying to wrest the franchise away from him. That's not going to happen. But you could see a scenario where if Jerry does follow through with litigation, that at some point that something could be done to punish the Cowboys, either in the form of a draft pick or some other type of punishment that could be levied because he is not stopping this. The bottom line is it's a horrible look, and it does look like he's simply throwing a tantrum because Ezekiel Elliott got suspended for 6 games, and it could ruin the Cowboys' season.
I wonder if he sees it that way. I wonder if he continues the fight or where he goes from here. Jason Reed, great to talk to you. Thanks.
Anytime, my man.
All right, and let's now turn to a man who needs no introduction. Coming in, Lewis Riddick, NFL analyst, taking a deep dive on the Jerry Jones versus the owners versus the NFL versus everybody. I don't know what's going on with the NFL. It's like constant fighting. Mm-hmm. This is not their year. Okay, so let's put this in perspective. Before all of this started, where did Jerry Jones stand in terms of the rankings of NFL owners?
Well, right, I think without a doubt, he's one of the elite of the elite, the best of the best. He's a guy who's really taken the game and kind of advanced it from a money-making standpoint and from an exposure standpoint to heights that maybe other owners really didn't have the foresight to do. So I know that he is someone that there are other owners who really look up to him, who really try to model his business approach after, they try to model their business approach after his. And he's someone who right now I think has some of the best vision as far as where this league really needs to go. I think he's very in tune to what is going on around him as far as how America is looking at the game, not just his team, America's team, but looking at the game and what the long-term ramifications can be, both positively and negatively, if there isn't some more awareness as to exactly what kind of opinion people have of the National Football League right now.
Jason Reed talked about how some owners, others out there, may be laughing at him because he's so angry throwing this tantrum over the Ezekiel Elliott situation. So that's where he was. Where does he stand now because of what's been happening over the past few days?
Well, I'm sure that there are some owners who kind of look at him and go, hey, look, we already know exactly what is really the impetus behind all of this, behind all of your interest in exactly what Roger Goodell is being paid. But you know what? I'm sure that if any other owner was put in this situation, they may not take it to the point where Jerry Jones is taking it, but they would have some of the same kinds of personal feelings that may be influencing their decisions as well about Roger Goodell or any other number of things that are going on.
You think he's lost any luster?
Well, I don't know if he's lost luster. I'm sure people are disappointed. Look, these are a bunch of guys. These are 32 guys with some of the biggest egos in the world. So I'm sure that right now they all have their personal opinions, and maybe they're talking amongst each other about, can you believe what he's doing, and saying the kind of things that we can't say on the air. But so be it. That's the way it goes. Look, I just know this. There are many owners, I'm sure, within the National Football League that would love to be in Jerry Jones' situation and owning his football team and the money that it's making and the exposure that it gets and having the life that Jerry Jones has, not to say that they don't have great lives themselves. Mm-hmm. This guy's a pioneer. He's someone who's been very good for the National Football League, and this kind of stuff happens.
They're still right up there at the top in terms of value. Now, let's talk about this. We talked about penalties. There's been some reports about the possibility of trying to get him to forfeit the franchise. Yeah. And again, reports.
Sure.
But then there's also been talk about the possibility of draft picks or suspensions if he continues this path. What do you think are the chances that the owners would actually do something like that to Jerry Jones?
As far as punishment relative to draft picks, I'm sure that's probably the kind of thing that will be on the table. That's the kind of thing that probably has the most amount of legs, that has the most amount of credibility. Mm-hmm. I mean, taking the franchise away from Jerry Jones and saying, forcing him to sell it, that just sounds ridiculous.
Yeah.
It sounds ridiculous to me where right now, where if you look at this objectively, Ryan, and you really look at this, what he wants is some transparency, regardless of what the impetus for this investigation is on his part or this slowing down is on his part.
Is it that, or does he want Goodell out?
I can't say that, but I'll just put it this way.
Mm-hmm.
For some, you just heard him say, why can't we slow this down and really get all the facts here and evaluate him subjectively as far as what kind of value is he really delivering to us as owners and as a league? Why wouldn't you want to do that? Why is it that some people are so in such a hurry to push this contract along? You know what? When you're negotiating contracts with their players all the time, they take their time. It's right up until the deadline. It's right up until how are we doing the best contract for the club relative to what this guy deserves to be paid. Why wouldn't you treat the commissioner the same way?
Is the concern that it shows Goodell that they don't have confidence in him if they say, we were negotiating with you, now we're stopping?
Well, I'm sure there is concern about that, but so be it. You know what? They should have thought about that beforehand. Why is he the only one who's bringing this up? Not to say that we in the media have more information than they do, but why would you be in such a hurry to pay a guy $49, $50 million, or even consider anything relative to lifetime usage of a private jet, lifetime health insurance for my entire family, given the subjective opinions that I think people by and large have about his performance?
You know, there is the side of this. He's a businessman. There's a lot of issues going on with the NFL.
Yeah.
Slow it down, see what happens.
Why not?
That seems what Jones is saying. All
right,
Lewis, great to talk to you.
You got it.
All right, well, when we come back, four of the best facing off in college hoops tonight, why the kids are running the show.